Abby, a tram. It's yellow. Carl, why are the trams in Manchester yellow?
Morning.
You swine. I don't know the answer to
Great
that.
Great way to start a video. So Carl's here. Say hello, Internet.
Hello, Internet.
You've met Carl before. I've come to Manchester. Technically, we've come to Rochdale to start to ride. How many are there?
99
tram stops. We're not getting on and off everyone, because that would take too long, but we're going to ride the entire tram network.
Yep.
So we can say we've visited the entire
the whole
tram system.
Lot.
We've spent £10 on a bus, tram and train ticket. Carl, can you do the history of Metrolink in 10 seconds? Go.
10 seconds, right. So 1992, Bury and Altrincham opens. Eccles branch is then opened after that. And then Rochdale, Oldham and Ashton branches are added. And the newest one is the Trafford Centre branch here.
That was very succinct. Well done.
This is a service to East Didsbury via Oldham. The next stop will be Rochdale Railway Station.
So not that we're timing it for like record purposes, but we did start at 10:41. So we're going to finish about 6:30. Oh, good.
Yeah.
8 hours with Carl. You've got 8 hours with Jeff, mate. Don't.
Yeah.
That's worse.
After we've gone over this bridge here, we've just left Rochdale. We then join the old British Rail alignment of the old Oldham Loop.
So I thought it was just Bury that used the old alignment. You're saying that Rochdale used the old alignment too?
Yeah, Rochdale Oldham was,
yes.
Parts of it, or most of it. Bury is an old BR alignment, and Altrincham is an old BR alignment as well.
And the rest is all purpose built?
Yes.
Right.
Service to East Didsbury via Oldham.
How many have we done?
We've done one, two, we've done four already.
Olden Mumps, number 9. There are some old tram tracks from the temporary tram solution.
Yes.
But what I find interesting is that obviously out in these sections, we're on the old railway alignment and the trams are fast and they're running at 50 miles an hour. And then when we get into purpose-built on the road sections, it's going to slow right down as it comes more twisty and people get in the way. Yeah. It's almost an hour to get into the centre of town from Rochdale on the tram, whereas if you got the train,
It's 12 minutes, wasn't it?
It was 12 minutes, yeah. If you get the Leeds, the express service. So 55 minutes to an hour from Rochdale. Hang on, why aren't we getting on here?
What? You can't get to Ashton from here. The service pattern doesn't run through here to Ashton.
This is Market Street.
This is Market Street, so we're going to have to go to Piccadilly Gardens to pick up an Ashton one.
Are we going to make it?
Yeah, get a trot on, we will.
Go,
yeah.
go. I want to see you trot. Carl ran, I sort of did a fast walk. There we go, we've made it easy. Could you explain what the DBL means on the dot matrix?
Double tram. A prized thing here on the Metrolink system, because you see a double tram, it's like, yeah, four carriages, more room, less crowded. The busiest lines, like the Altrincham, Bury, Ashton, run double most of the time.
So on the way out to Ashton, that'll be 35. You've got a schedule. I didn't realise you drew up a schedule.
Yeah. So generally, I mean, I've built a lot of slack into this, but as things stand, we're bang on.
It's Droylsden. Did I say that was
bang on? Well done. 10 out of 10.
Did I pronounce it right? Thank you. 31, and Ashton will be 35. I'm throwing a massive spanner in the works. I'm suggesting to Carl that the train that we're about to get from Ashton, we stay on past Victoria and go to Salford, and then the nearest tram stop to Salford Crescent is Anchorage, and then we get onto the Eccles branch. We do the Eccles branch first. I'm trying to argue my case, and Carl's not happy about it. Can we walk from Salford Crescent to Anchorage and save a bit of time that way?
It's about 15 to 20 minutes.
And then
we do everything in reverse.
So we're on the regular train back into Victoria. I almost convinced Carl to do what I'm going to call the Salford Shuffle, but we decided to deliberate if we're going to stick to our original plan. So at Victoria, we go around to Piccadilly and then get the train out to
East Didsbury.
Okay. There's a Piccadilly tram in one minute.
Yeah.
So we'll get that.
Another win.
It's pulling in now. Here we go. So we're going through centre of Manchester. Shude Hill is number 36. We're doing all right, says Carl. You can't see me, but I'm smiling behind the mask. I'm surprised Eric Clapton hasn't re-released Behind the Mask. He'd make a killing.
This is a service to
The 1358 is now plus five, so it's 1 o'clock at Piccadilly.
Could we make that train?
Possibly, if we leg it like a pair of lunatics, yeah.
So we could get the train before?
Yeah.
Because it's running late?
Yes.
We're now approaching Piccadilly. Travel later.
This late running train will put us 10 minutes up.
Yeah.
On schedule. Thanks, Northern.
Is it Northern or is it a TPE?
Might be the TFW. Oh.
We made the right decision.
The knock-on effect is good.
Yeah. Whose stupid idea was it to go to Salford? That's a no, that's what I'm called. What a ridiculous idea that would have been. East Didsbury. How many is that? I'll put it in the corner, it's alright.
We're going to reverse at Firswood. Yeah. It's not a line on platform, is it? It's an up and over. Yeah.
Reversing at Firswood, so we repeat Firswood. Sorry, no,
We'll repeat Chorlton and St Werburgh's Road.
It's Chorlton and the Wheelers, Chorlton.
Yes, because the Cosgrove Hall Studios were in
Chorlton. Can you hum the theme tune to Chorlton and the Wheelers? He's doing it! But we're getting this tram all the way to the airport.
All the way to the airport,
this bit is a bit tedious.
Yes.
And it's a single, not a double. Oh no.
This is a service to Manchester Airport.
We've just left Withenshaw Park.
Yeah.
Moor Road is next. So Withenshaw Park is 49, Moor Road is 50. So right now,
halfway,
yeah. And we're just over the 3 hour mark.
3 hours, 5 minutes.
So we could be, so halfway in 3 hours, could do the whole thing in six hours, maybe just over 6 hours. Where are we, sir?
Manchester Airport, finally.
We're now approaching Manchester Airport, where you can change for National Rail.
Or, as by our rules, which we're allowed to do because we set them, we're going to get a taxi, like this.
Thank you, mate.
Thank you!
Thank you!
We made it?
Yeah, we're on.
We got snacks just in time, so hang on. Altrincham 61.
This is a service to Piccadilly.
It's Dane Road 66, Stretford is next.
67.
So that marks the two-thirds of the way through. Carl has the stopwatch. We have been going for
4 hours and 1 minute.
So we could finish in 6 hours. I'm gonna go say 6 hours, 10 minutes.
6:30.
Cornbrook, number 70. So we get whatever comes next, whether it's one up to Eccles
or
Trafford Centre. Oh, the next one's in East Didsbury. So Trafford Centre in 5-6 minutes. So we go to Trafford Centre first.
Yeah.
All right. This is Pomona. When I think of Pomona, I think of Paloma Faith. That's the least used station on the Manchester Tram network. So we're approaching
Parkway,
which is station number
75.
And this branch is
brand new, opened in March 2020. There's talk of extending it out to Port Salford, but nothing's happening of yet, but Trafford Centre at the moment.
Alright, so Parkway, 75.
75,
three
yes.
quarters.
Yes, nearly there.
So we got a taxi to Eccles. Oh, that's annoying.
Yeah.
I feel like we
that one just
I feel like we just missed one. If we'd got the one before, we might have finished in 6 hours. As it is, we'll finish in 6 hours. 6 hours, 10, that's right, but it's going via Media City. The sun's come out, it's a nice day. Made it to Media City, that's number 83. The tram driver changes ends and drives out the other end. Like that. He made it to St Peter's Square. That's number 89. Are you exhausted? I'm exhausted.
It's been a long day, hasn't
I'm
it?
I'm just tired now. I'm just really tired.
It's been a long day.
So we're making a change here to go back through Exchange Square, change to Victoria,
yep.
And then we'll pick up the Bury train.
Home stretch.
Yep. I want to have a nap. And we'll probably finish at around 5 o'clock.
Yeah, there or thereabouts.
So that'll be around 6 hours, 20 minutes. At least the sun's out now. What, look, the camera's been slowly angling down and down and down. It's just gonna, it's gonna fall. That's not a T68, is it?
It's not, no.
What's a T68?
T68 was the rolling stock that we used to have. They were hard as nails and blessed with the looks that only a mother could love. They're slowly phased out. I think the last one was in service 2012, 2013.
So what are these? What are these known as?
Bombardier M5000s.
Which are better?
Oh, these by a mile. Yeah, far better.
But a T68 sounds like a robot from the Terminator franchise, doesn't it?
And they look like it, yes.
Changing at Victoria.
Yeah.
When's the next Bury tram? 10 minutes?
I'm guessing it'll be 10 minutes.
Got time for a tea then?
This is a service to Bury.
Yeah. How do you pronounce it?
This is the Bar.
This is the Bury line.
It is indeed.
Which is an old British rail line.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they used to run from Victoria to Bury every 15 minutes. So it's the same journey what we've just done now on our final leg.
So proper trains used to come down here.
They did.
And now it got converted to tram.
Yes, late 91. And then obviously Fritz opened then in April 92. Six hours, 21.
So we're the final time of...
6 hours, 21 minutes and 31 seconds.
We're sat in the little gardens with the statue behind Bury Interchange bus station, tram station. Thanks, Carl.
Pleasure.
Yeah. Take 6 hours. If you were doing it via tube train into rules, you couldn't use a taxi. You'd have to use public transport only. We could have done it a bit quicker.
Yeah.
But it was fun to do.
We were lucky, I think. We were lucky. Yeah. We did well. Yeah.
We could have made the Eccles tram one sooner to be 10 minutes faster.
Yep.
But just over 6 hours.
Yeah.
That's it. I am exhausted. I'm so tired. And all I've done is sat on trams all day. Carl Florzak, Northern Correspondent, shuffled papers. Thank you very much. See you next time.
Bye-bye, folks.